Thank you very much for inviting me to speak today. I'm delighted to be able to talk to you about the support that ETF have provided the National College over the last 18 months. At the National College, we are on an exciting journey. When I started on this project, I'd spent 15 years working in, with and around the FE sector, but nothing prepared me for setting up a brand new college. There isn't a dummy's guide around that tells you what you need to do, so we're very much on a learning journey. ETF have been a valuable resource to my team and I to enable us to build on effective practice. So let me give you a bit of context about the National College for High Speed Rail, and then I'll explain to you a bit about the support that ETF have provided us with. So the National College for High Speed Rail is a brand new incorporated further education college. I believe it's only the second one since 1993. We open in September 2017 and we will deliver level 4 and level 5 provision only. As our name suggests, the higher technical training that we will offer is focused on high speed rail, but by definition we will also develop skills for the wider rail sector and for the transport industry. This industry is one of huge investment by government and huge growth in employment opportunities, but the skills development in the appropriate areas at the appropriate level has been woefully lacking, and it's our job to turn that round. As a college, we have no legacy to call upon. Our team has grown from 4 people to 20 people since May this year, and our buildings are under construction. Let me tell you, expectation is huge of us. DfE have ambitions that we will reach Ofsted outstanding within 3 years of operation, and the industry want us to be world class and leading the way. And as a new college, we only get one opportunity to get this right, otherwise our employers will vote with their feet. Our curriculum is currently taking shape, with our year one offering currently being promoted to our employers as we speak. We made a conscious decision to split the curriculum across the two sites that we have in Birmingham and Doncaster. There are some common elements, as this slide shows, but ultimately, most part, the curriculum is very different. Over the next 2 years, we expect to go from delivering higher apprenticeships to also delivering a level 4 non-apprenticeship route. We will offer leadership and management at level 5 and have a suite of CPD provision wrapped around our core offering to help upskill the workforce. We are currently delivering our level 4 trailblazer apprenticeship in high speed rail. This will focus on skills development in new and emerging technologies that are coming into the rail sector. The apprenticeship is being structured to include a 12-week induction, then an option of 8 specialist pathways to provide core knowledge, skills and behaviours that are needed for transforming the rail sector and to move it into the future. In September 2017, only 2 of these pathways will be available. To help deliver this apprenticeship, we need high quality staff who have understanding of engineering, but we also need those who've got understanding of technology, of programming and of where the sector's going. To achieve this, we are looking to have a hybrid model of core employed people as well as a group of industry specialists who come direct from the employers we're working with. We are looking at specialist facilities to provide some of the environment, but we are also cultivating our own. As a key part of our setup is ensuring that the leadership of the college is right and that the staff hold the latest thinking and sound understanding of the further education sector, we've been working with ETF to make sure that we get that training developed and implemented. Our vision is to pioneer excellence in higher technical training. We can't do this if we're not aware of what's going on both in the rail sector but also in further education. Investing in people development is huge. At a time when we need to be growing diversity in the workforce, it means that rather than employing people who have the here and now skills, we need to employ those people who have potential. But in order for us as an organisation to realise that potential, we need to put a package of support around them for development. Now, this slide is not rocket science. I'm sure everybody in the room recognises the process that we're going through. But for me, it is important that everybody who comes to work, both on the development of the college and the delivery of the college, are right, have the right skills, have their skills being developed, and know what's happening both in rail and in FE. For us, this work has begun at the top. Our Board of Governors was formed of businesses and stakeholders, 95% of whom had not previously acted as a governor on a board for the school or a college. They absolutely have their finger on the pulse of what's going on in the rail industry, acting on corporate boards, but have limited understanding of the statutory and regulatory environment of the FE sector, and their learning curve is great. As some of the top industrialists of the country being on our board, they have limited time and a limited attention span to undertake the required training. Through the conversations with governors, ETF have set out a plan of development that needs to take place. They've also looked at the different methods of delivering that training to make sure that it is right for our governors. And that is including face-to-face, online, podcasts, e-bulletins. This has meant that members of our corporation have been able to embed that training into their working lives. So when they're on the train, the plane, they can take advantage of that and make sure that they're doing the training that we need them to undertake. We've also attached hour-long sessions to the end of our corporation meetings where ETF come in and deliver that training, bringing in experts from around the FE sector to put the training into context so that our board members can understand how that applies and the role that they need to take. In the last 6 months, we've reviewed the skills of our governors to make sure that they have the right mix and balance that we're going to need as we go operational. At our meeting in December, ETF will be reviewing the outcome of the work that they have been doing so we can start addressing the gaps that exist. ETF have also been able to undertake neutral conversations with our board members to make sure that we've got clear understanding about what they want their role to be within the college and we can really maximise the benefit of that. Where we were as an advisory group talking about the vision for the college is going to be very different to where we need to be when we go operational in September. The training plan that we had has now been updated and we'll be looking to evolve our corporation membership to ensure it's fit for purpose moving forward. We started working with ETF at the end of 2015. We were at a point of our development where we wanted to understand what good and effective practice exists in the sector. As I mentioned at the beginning of our presentation, the National College has been established from no legacy. However, the FE sector has a wealth of experience and effective practice that has been developed. To identify this in our own right would have been a near impossible mission. However, ETF have been able to step in and support us to be able to signpost us to effective and good practice that already exists in the sector where colleges are excelling or demonstrating new approaches in particular aspects. We don't want or need to start again where there's already practice that we can build on and learn from elsewhere. ETF have been able to signpost us to this practice, but also give us insight into emerging thinking. We've had a series of reference sites identified where we've been able to send our governors so they've been able to see that practice taking place and talk to other people within FE colleges. For both my governors and the SMT, we have been able to access training and resources to develop our thinking, understand the latest regulatory framework, and ensure we are building into our thinking critical areas such as PREVENT. For me personally, as a new chief executive of an FE college, they have been a vital sounding board to ensure that I am looking at things and how they're going, and I'm also looking at what the art of the possible is for this new college. We need to learn from the experience of others so we don't make the same mistakes or miss the opportunity that we have. The investment in my team will continue to make sure we are delivering the best to our learners and for our employers. I see the support of ETF can provide us with an ongoing relationship that adapts as we mature. In my opinion, it is one way that we can make sure that we are continually improving to make long-lasting change to an industry sector that is in real need. Thank you very much.